Welcome to this new topic, that is hypersonic cruise vehicle test puts India in elite club. Recently that test has been happened. What is it? What are the topics behind it? What is jet stream? What is ramjet engine? We will all discuss in this lecture. So the Defense Research and Development Organization, that is by DRDO, conducted a flight test of the hypersonic technology demonstrator, that is vehicle, so HSTDV. This is the short form of this one. Moving towards the lecture. So what are the different types of engines available to us? Okay, so if you went if you have seen airplane, so this kind of, as you see in the background, that wings are there, like if I can draw the plane, so it is something like that. And so the wings is like something like that. Okay, so you can see here it is two engines are there in both the aircraft. Okay, and it is something like that. In this elevator the fan is rotating, okay, and the exhaust is going back. So as it's going, as it's, the pressure is given back, so thus it makes the plane to move forward. That is your Newton's third law. Every action has an equal and opposite reaction. Okay, so whenever the fuel burns between here, so that will make your plane to move forward. Okay, so we will see what is jet engine. Jet engine, that is, that will be present in your normal plane. So when the turbine in the plane compresses the air present on the wing, so let us suppose that if it is your that engine that is present on your aircraft wing, so here it is your wing, so when the air enters into it, it compresses the air present in the wing, it compresses the air present in the wing, and this engine compresses the air and push it backward, so in this direction. Due to the Newton's third law, the aircraft is being pushed forward. That is normal jet engine. This is normal jet engine. Okay, now we will see that ramjet engine. In ramjet engine there is no fan. In ramjet engine there is no fan, and when a stream of air comes into it, the fuel is injected, that from here the fuel is injected, so lots of fuel is injected, and then air heats up and get expand, like as the air get expanded, then it suddenly expand, and as it expand, so it pushes the aircraft at very, that it went here, so it pushes the aircraft at very high speed, and air inside it subsonic. What do you understand with subsonic? That the speed, that the air speed is lesser than the sound of the speed. Okay, that is called your subsonic. That comes under the ramjet engine. Okay, now we will see, what is a scramjet. What is a scramjet? In scramjet, that supersonic combustion of the ramjet, that ramjet is there, ramjet means there is no fan, no fan is present. So in this, air which comes under it, that are already compressed, that the air which is coming in the scramjet is already a supersonic, that the last part, that last part that happens, that air is already supersonic and it ignites the air and push the air at hypersonic speed when the fuel burns. So it converts that supersonic speed to the hypersonic speed when the fuel burns. So in the ramjet engine, the flight moves at the three times of the speed of the sound. But in the scramjet engine, it achieves 6 times of the speed of the sound. Okay, that is the difference between ramjet and scramjet engine. So in the ramjet engine, when the air comes, there is no fan. In the scramjet also, there is no fan. When the air comes, it compresses it, and fuel get burns that makes that at very high speed, that makes aircraft to move at very high speed, and air that air inside that comes, that is a subsonic, that is lesser than the speed of the sound. And in the scramjet, that air already comes as a supersonic, and then it ignites the fuel and convert into hypersonic speed. Okay, now the question is arise that how the air that already comes in a scramjet is already converted into supersonic speed. Okay, how it works, we will see in this slide. That in the scramjet, it will not function till the aircraft did not achieve the highest speed. That that threshold is there, that one threshold is defined, that one threshold is defined. Until that, when the aircraft did not achieve that highest speed, it will not start. So first it will attain the minimum speed, that what is the minimum speed to get air compressed as supersonic, and then the scramjet engine will start, then work for convert into that hypersonic speed. Understand that in scramjet, it will not function till the aircraft did not achieve the highest speed. First, it will attain the minimum speed required, that is the threshold value, by the solid rocket motor. Okay, as I have said that in ramjet engine, that is supersonic, will be 3 times the sound of speed, and in scramjet, that is hypersonic, it will be 6 times the speed of the sound. Okay. Now, what is Mach number? This topic I have added one extra thing, that in the next slide there was one concept of Mach 3. So just to explain that Mach term, I have introduced this slide, I have attached this slide. So what is Mach number? So Mach number is a dimensionless quantity in a fluid dynamics that representing the ratio of flow of velocity past a boundary to the local speed of the sound. So it will be difficult to understand, just see this mathematical representation, you will understand it, that it is a ratio between the speed of the object and with the speed of the sound. So whatever the ratio you will get, that will be termed to be as Mach number. Okay, so if your Mach number is less than 1.0, so it will be your subsonic. If it is equal to a 1.0, then it will be a transonic. If it is greater than 1, then it will be supersonic, and 5, then it will be called as hypersonic. Okay, so this is just a Mach number. This definition is a little bit too difficult to understand. Just remember this mathematical representation, that the object of the, that the speed of that object by the speed of the sound, whatever the number you will get, that the ratio will be, whatever the ratio you will get, that will be your Mach number. And just compare this chart, you will get that this flight or that object is your subsonic, transonic, or supersonic, or hypersonic. Okay, as per your Mach number. Okay, so what is the significance of this test? So with the hypersonic technology, demonstrator technology, cruise missiles can now travel at hypersonic speed. Now our cruise missiles which can travel at hypersonic speed, which can achieve that high speed and attack our enemies all on in the war kind of situation, it will be very helpful for us. Okay, testing paves the way for development of more critical technologies, materials, and hypersonic vehicles. It will help in the development of hypersonic cruise missiles, already said above. Most engines used in the ramjet engine, which operates at supersonic speeds of up to Mach 3, that I have discussed here. So here it is talking about Mach 3, if it operates at the supersonic speed for the ramjet engine. And it puts India in a select club of nations that have demonstrated this technology. That there are very selected nations, that very selected nations which are in the club of this demonstration of this technology, that converting of that supersonic to the hypersonic speed of the vehicles present in the country. Okay, that will be term that will be used as an in our scramjet engine. Okay, earlier it was ramjet engine which was working on supersonic speed. Now it is working as hypersonic speed. Okay, I hope you have understand all those concepts, that is subsonic and supersonic, how it is working, and how we have achieved that scramjet in an hypersonic speed. And I hope you like the video. Please subscribe my channel if you liked it, and you can pay me by subscribing the channel only. If you have any suggestions or you want any on-demand video lecture, please ping me on Twitter handle. The description, the Twitter handle link will be given in your description. Thank you.